मीम न्यूज एक्सप्रेस की ताज़ा तरीन खबरों के लिए सब्सक्राइब करें हमारा चैनल और बेल बटन दबाना ना भूलें।
It is said that a provision for 8,000 crore rupees is made for Jammu and Kashmir. It is far less than that was what was promised and the dreams that were shown to the people of Jammu and Kashmir. In any case, it does not, whatever are the projected figures do not reflect the concerns of Jammu and Kashmir. And to illustrate civil aviation, Avantipura Airport in South Kashmir stands transport to civil authorities, no provision is made for that. Ministry of Food Processing, Jammu and Kashmir produces 2.5 million metric tons of fresh food. There is infrastructure only for 5% of the fresh food produced. No allocations or no demands under for Ministry of Food Processing and no provision for Jammu and Kashmir. Same way, health and family welfare. In far-flung areas, we don't have any facility for basic health amenities and to meet acute health problems like dialysis. We don't have it. People end up spending 2 to 3 lakh rupees from middle-level families on dialysis without any source to support. Then Ministry of Road and Transport. Jammu and Kashmir highway remains blocked for 150 days in a year. 4 tunnels are under, 1 is under construction and 3 are proposed. We don't have any promises made, any locations made on road transport and highways. Again, tourism is backbone of Jammu and Kashmir. We don't get any commitments, fresh commitments, adequate allocations, In the bill, nothing is earmarked to promote tourism in Jammu and Kashmir. And Ministry of Women and Child Development. Same way, it is almost a non-starter. We had 7 commissioners there. I mean, one of the areas untruths on which the 5th August decision was marketed was that they don't have a Women's Development Commission, they don't have a RTI, Information Commission, they have nothing, we were pushed to Stone Age. 2 months before that, Jammu Kashmir was projected as the place where there is maximum women participation, they are touching new heights. It was only 2 months thereafter, there was U-turn and telling us that you are living in Stone Age and we are now going to push you on path of development. In any case, 7 commissions were wound up, which were in existence, Honorable Minister knows. Nothing has been provided. Again, railways, a promise was made for Baramulla, Kofara railway line, Jammu Punch railway line. Only a promise, nothing has been achieved on ground and no provision in this bill. So these are key areas, should have been thrust areas and focus should have been on these areas in the current bill. But unfortunately, Jammu and Kashmir does not get the attention that was promised when 5th August this revocation of special status was announced and tried to be marketed on untruths and on projecting that all these facilities are not available in Jammu and Kashmir and we want to push Jammu and Kashmir on the path of development. So this, in a way, from the viewpoint of Jammu and Kashmir, is disappointing. And we expect Honorable Minister to respond to all this once we get the reply to whatever has been projected. Sir, I would take this opportunity to make a request for a discussion on Jammu and Kashmir. We have been demanding, even Honorable Prime Minister had promised on day one that we will go for a short discussion on Jammu and Kashmir. Time and again, we have been making a request. I would take this opportunity to make a request to Honorable Speaker to ask the government agree to a short discussion so that all these points, those are now to be, dilated upon by Honorable Minister, can be dealt with in a dispassionate manner, in an objective manner, fair manner during that discussion. And again, tomorrow is birthday of, we say Baba Ikum, we call him father of the nation, Sheikh Mohammed Abdullah. I hope it has been reported, the unconfirmed reports are that district administration is not allowed even a small group of people to go to Mazar. This is the level of normalcy that is being projected to just offer prayers. After all, he was the leader who went all the way to Security Council, UN Security Council. And Dr. Farooq Abdullah is the person who was deputed to Geneva to defend human rights record of the country. And Umar Abdullah is the person who was City Air Minister, Foreign Minister under
Vajpayee. Budget ke alawa, Mani Sadashya, aap shunni kaal mein bol lena. Thik hai, Mani Sadashya?
Only.
Asauddin Obesi.
Only this request.
Sir. Hi. Sir, bahut bahut shukriya, sir.
जब अग्रवाल जी चेयर पर बैठे थे, जब इशू चल रहा था,
इन्होंने वो भी दो मिनट बोल लेंगे,
नहीं
इनको भी बोलने दे दो मिनट, फिर उनके बाद उनको बोलें, जम्मू कश्मीर पे डिबेट शुरू हो जाएगी, नहीं
नहीं सर, इन्होंने सिर्फ क्लेरिफिकेशन, सर दो मिनट में क्लेरिफिकेशन करते हैं, ओनली टू मिनट सर,
एक मिनट, सुरेश जी आप दो मिनट और बोल लें, दो मिनट और बोल ले जम्मू कश्मीर
पे। Honorable Minister did reply to whatever I said earlier. There is no occasion for him to reply again. But my request was that this cannot be a substitute for short discussion because that is going to be a frank and fair discussion, a dispassionate discussion where everybody will have a chance. But now, first is that in the name of normalcy, whatever is being stated, that is far from reality. And arrest of political leaders across all the political parties, how can you just? And second is internet facilities for the students, 1.5 million students, and hoteliers and businessmen. They cannot communicate with the rest of the world. They cannot receive orders. I mean, business is affected badly. Those were my words.